Good morning. This, my friends, is a rusted out electrical box. The top, you can see, has separated from the rest of the box because of rust. It has been covered over one time by someone that put tile on it, and then it continued to deteriorate. Now, I plan to show you today a quick fix to save $3,000 to $5,000 in the event they come out and tell you you need new electrical boxes. So, here's the work that I did yesterday. These were just as equally as terrible. And I will make an attempt to show you what tools you will need if you decide to save the money yourself. It's really pretty simple. You'll need cream hardener and some Bondo. These things are generally used typically for rusted out nasty auto body repairs. They're also used for fixing trim, doing trim carpentry and doors and things like that. They call it something else, but it's basically the same thing. It's Bondo. They just put a different label on it, some for wood, some for metal. Pretty good product. You have to mix both the hardener with compound in order to get it to work, and then you only have a few, maybe a minute and a half to work the product before it sets up hard. And so today we're going to do this box, and we're going to save on this job for myself, since this is our place, about $3,000 to $5,000, because we've had some estimates. And so here we go. Now, because your time is valuable, I didn't want to take the time to show you do the same thing over and over again to all three of these boxes. However, you'll note that they no longer have holes in the top of them. And although it's a rough finish, we're getting ready to paint them. This isn't like a Ferrari or anything like that, so all we have to do is make it watertight and to pass inspection. And that's what we're going to do, and that's what we've done. And now we'll paint them and be done. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye. Now I'm going to start out by tearing this old nasty tile or whatever top off. And to do that, I'm going to use this chisel. And a putty trowel. And maybe a hammer. I'm not really sure if we're going to need the hammer or not. live near the ocean, so this is a typical problem after 20, 30 years for these boxes to get less damage as they get neglected. And this allows water into the circuit breaker system for the building unit and can also get one cited for electrical violation. Now what we intend to do with this is to make it like a brand new car, because we're using auto body filler to make the repair. No permit necessary, because you're not undoing or putting back together any wires. Simply making the container watertight again, so that water does not get into the box and damage the electrical circuit breaker or short the wires out. Major issues of salt here, so that's why it's salt in the air, because of the ocean. And so this kind of problem exists in a lot of places that are close to the ocean and plain old boxes that are out in the rain. So at any rate, I'll continue. Now you want to get this pretty clean, because what's left of the metal here you're going to have to use to get the Bondo to adhere to. So you want to scrape it and sweep it off with, I use a paintbrush, or you could use a wet and dry vac to get all the stuff off there. Thank you. Alright, after you've sufficiently scraped it, you'll want to sand it down a little bit to try and make sure that the compound, the mixture of the hardener and the compound adheres properly to the, what's left of the surface of the box. This one's pretty badly eaten up on this side, but we'll make it just like a brand new car here in a little bit, so stay with me. We got some sandpaper here now, and rough up the surface a little bit. Not that it's not rough already, but we want that rust mostly. If you can get the more rust that you can get off, the better off you'll be on the bonding of the bond. Like I said, safety glasses, rubber soles, either boots or shoes, so that in the event you do get into any electrical problems, you'll have a better chance. When I use the Bondo, I'll be using rubber gloves, which will also assist in insulating me from danger. The system is grounded or should be grounded. You want to make sure that you find the ground and make sure it's properly grounded so that one doesn't become the ground. At any rate, always use caution when working with electricity or around electricity. The next thing you'll want to do after you've properly prepared the surface is to cut your fiberglass mesh to the proper size to cover all these holes, because you're going to put a thin layer of Bondo on the top of the box, and then you will stick the fiberglass mesh onto the Bondo. This keeps the Bondo from falling through the holes and ended up in the bottom of the box, and you're still having a big hole in your box. So you'll need a roll of fiberglass mesh as well as your Bondo, your hardening agent, something to mix the compound on. You'll need your chisel and your a way to clean the excess residue of the top of the box. I use a paintbrush. You will need sandpaper, rubber gloves, rubber sole shoes, safety glasses, and scissors to cut the mesh with, and we'll proceed with the program. Thanks for watching. we cut two pieces the same size for this part of the operation, since we have the same size length to deal with. Another thing you'll want to note when you're done with your roll, it's got a little bit of sticky stuff like tape on it, so you always want to bend your mesh over on your mesh again so that you know where the starting point is, because once you lose track of that starting point on a roll like this, it's very difficult to find the starting point, and you can end up wasting your entire roll the next time you go to use it. So, that having been said, now I'm going to mix the compound, and then I'll be back here with you on this. Okay, the next step in this operation is mixing the Bondo putty in order to put it onto the top of the box with your fiberglass mesh, and then after that has hardened, which may take a few minutes, and then I will apply a couple, three more layers of the Bondo after I work the Bondo to try and keep it smooth. Important thing in working Bondo is after you set it and you put it on, and wait till it gets semi-hard, and you know, fairly hard but still workable. That's the time to do your sanding and stuff, because if you wait for a couple, 3 hours, it's going to be so hard it'll be difficult to get a smooth layer on top. That's one of the tricks of the auto body trim carpenter people like me that do this kind of thing. You work the Bondo when it's semi-hard, because it makes your job a lot easier and faster if you can do that part of it, the close to finish part, while the stuff is still not quite set up. So, anyway, here we go on to mixing the Bondo. Put on your rubber gloves. Bondo putty and your cream hardener, your mixing board, which I use cardboard in this case, your putty knife, this one's no stranger to the range, obviously, and you mix your Bondo. Start with your Bondo putty. And then you need to mix your hardener, cream hardener. Now, you don't want to use too much of this because it'll harden too quickly and you won't get a good job. If you just kind of, like I do it because I've done it enough, I know what I'm doing, but you just kind of put a little bit out there on top. You don't use near as much as the as what you use as a Bondo putty. And you'll want to mix it till it's thoroughly mixed and red, but then as quickly as possible, get it on the product that you're trying to maintain because it hardens fairly quickly. Now, I've already done the primary coat over the damaged area, and I put one coat of the Bondo mixture over the box, lightly around the holes that would have the material would have fallen through. Now the Bondo is hardened to the point where I can put another one of these fiberglass strips across the hole up in the corner and across the side. So now I'm ready to mix another batch of Bondo, which I previously showed you, which I will repeat the same process, and then we will carry on with this program. Thank you. I'm mixing the Bondo again, and you want to get it thoroughly mixed to where it comes to about a pinkish kind of color. Then it's ready to put on. And I have my pre-cut mesh ready to put on once I put the Bondo in place to stick it to the box. See how it's already, how quickly it hardens up. Right now it's already too set to use any further on this little bunch that I just made. And so the longer you have to let it sit before you can start working it. So we'll cut off our extra fiberglass mesh. Ridges out, make it easier later. See how easy that comes off when it's semi-hard? You let that completely harden, these ridges, you would have to work a long time to sand it down with hand tools in order to get the little ridges out where the putty knife or trowel left marks in the bondo. This is real similar to working with drywall joint compound. They have a lot of people sand joint compound, however, I wet sand it, which is basically just using a wet rag and just going over it with a damp wet rag, and it accomplishes the same purpose as sandpaper because it dissolves the outer layer of the joint compound and works as a sandpaper. It fills in the low spots and builds up the high spots and makes for a lot easier work for those of you who contemplated doing drywall or some joint work in your house. The dry sanding seems to be a lot faster and make a lot smoother. Well, not necessarily smoother, but makes the work a lot easier for me. Now, also when I'm doing work with drywall and joint compound, sometimes I'll mix a little bit of plaster of Paris in with the joint compound mixture. Makes it set up a little faster. Now we're ready for another coat of the bondo. We'll cover the whole top this time and around the edges that have been previously prepared. Then I'll have to work on this one side because it's pretty bad rough over here. So I'll mix that and I'll get back with you. Now, just doing the same as I had done before, putting the fiberglass mesh on where the holes are in the box, mixing a little more bondo. I'm just mixing a small amount because I just need to stick a little bit piece on this side before I coat the whole box and complete the project ready for painting. that set up just a little bit. And we're going to trim it up and put one more, two more coats on, and we should be finished, ready to do finish sanding. All right, now I'm just going to do a little trimming on this fiberglass mesh so that my next coating can be close to a final coating. So I'll mix some more of the Bondo, and we'll move towards finishing this project. How quickly that stuff hardens. you have to keep your tools clean, or relatively clean, or you'll get lumps and clumps in it. See how easy that is to work when it's still yet a little bit soft? You'd be surprised at the difference that makes in time when you can work it off that easy as opposed to trying to take it off later when it's really, really hard. It just saves hours of sanding and finish work.
Thank you.
And here's our finished product. And you'll note that the rust is gone from the tops of the boxes. And we're ready for inspection. Original estimates for this job, had we paid someone to replace the boxes, were between $3,500 and $6,000. We have invested about 2 days of our time, myself and my father, Dan, and we have a total in this of about $150. And we made a great savings, and it'll probably last another 15 or 20 years.